All right, listen up. We're back in my bedroom, which kind of seems fitting for this video, because we need to talk about your erections, or better yet, your lack of erections. So look, there is a lot that contributes to ED, but what you cannot do is bury your head in the sand and pretend that it's not a problem. So today, at least for the next couple of minutes, it's okay to talk about ED and some of the things that you can do right now to get your old self back. Stay with me, my friend, because it's all coming right up. Okay, welcome back to my channel, and as always, I'm glad that you're here. So really quick, just in case you are new to my channel, first of all, welcome. I'm John, and I'm the founder of 40overfashion.com, and I've been creating content since 2014 that's been helping men look better, feel better, and have more confidence. And on this channel, we talk all about men's lifestyle topics for grown-ups. So if you can get on board with that, please consider subscribing and join in. Okay, we can't start off a conversation about a potential medical issue without me giving the disclaimer that I am not a doctor. I do a ton of research for topics like this prior to filming, so please just be aware that if you're looking for more medical advice, please consult your local healthcare professional. Now, we can't talk about your wiener health without first talking about testosterone. So on average, your testosterone starts dropping by about 1% per year by the age of 30. So as you can imagine, by the time you're in your 40s or 50s, a lot of men experience symptoms of low testosterone. So this means overall sluggishness or a lack of energy throughout the day, as well as reduced sex drive and more difficulty getting and maintaining an erection. So let's talk about some of the things you can do to help prevent that. Now, first, lower your sugar intake. So most of us love sugar, right? We love sugar in our food, in our desserts, and in our alcohol. However, there's still ongoing research, but studies are showing that sugar intake reduces your testosterone levels by about 25%, and it stays low for up to like 2 hours after consuming that sugar. So if you're eating a diet with excessive amounts of sugar, you could definitely benefit by changing your eating habits. And if you think about it, that explains your morning wood, otherwise known as nocturnal penile tumescence. Because you haven't consumed sugar for like the last 6 to 8 hours that you've been asleep, your testosterone levels are at their highest in the morning, and that's one of the reasons you get that morning wood. And speaking of morning wood, next is getting enough sleep. Now, before you go clicking off this video thinking that getting more sleep will not help you get a harder erection, you're wrong. Let me explain. So the amount of sleep that you get and your testosterone levels are connected. I've read a lot of very interesting studies on this, and one study found that after about a week of only getting like 5.5 hours of sleep per night, men showed a 10 to 15% decrease in their testosterone levels, even in younger men. So when you sleep, your body is repairing itself and working to rebuild muscle tissue and also trying to fight off infection. And of course, this happens a lot more efficiently when you're asleep because your body's in a state of rest. Your body also runs a series of checks, so to speak, just to make sure everything is operating as it should. And one sign of that happening is erections at night when you're sleeping. On average, you'll get like 3 to 5 erections per night that last about 20 minutes or so. Some of those will even wake you up. And you want this to happen. So if you're not getting those normal erections at night, you should talk to your doctor or a healthcare professional because potentially you could have some beginning medical issues like nerve malfunction, diabetes, arterial disease, or high blood pressure. Now, because I just mentioned talking to a healthcare professional, that can be a really difficult thing to do. I mean, no man wants to admit that King Richard and the twins aren't working. It's a man thing, right? And most men just brush it off or blame themselves. But in fact, about 75% of men do nothing about it, which is insane. And that's why I partnered up once again with Get Roman, who is sponsoring this video, because if you're not doing anything about it, it's important to know that Roman is there with the advice that you want and the help you need with no shame. We all want to be healthy for ourselves and our families and, of course, live a healthy life, but part of a healthy life includes a healthy sex life. But if you struggle with any type of erectile dysfunction like low sex drive or not being able to get a full erection or even an erection at all, you probably don't feel like your best self because you know what you're capable of. So if you want some help with ED, Roman connects you with a real US licensed healthcare professional who can prescribe the medicine that you need. With Roman, you can get a free online evaluation and ongoing care for ED, all from the comfort and privacy of your own home. A healthcare professional will work with you to find the best treatment plan, and if medication is appropriate, Roman will ship you real medicine with free two-day shipping. The whole process is very straightforward, simple, and discreet. And getting started is also very simple. Just go to getroman.com/fashion and complete an online visit. Erectile dysfunction used to be tough to talk about, but now there's Roman. Complete an online visit today and connect with a healthcare professional and take care of it. Just go to getroman.com/fashion and get $15 off your first order of ED treatment, a free online visit, and free two-day shipping. That's getroman.com/fashion for $15 off your first order of ED treatment, getroman.com/fashion. The next thing I want to talk about is your alcohol consumption. I mean, we probably all heard the term whiskey dick, and it kind of relates back to sugar intake a little bit. The American Heart Association suggests no more than 150 calories or 36 grams of added sugar per day for most men. So if you're having a few old fashions with muddled sugar cubes or rum and cokes or a few pina coladas, which by the way contain more than 13 grams of sugar, on top of whatever else you ate that day, you can start to see where the sugar intake gets a little bit out of control. So not only that, but since your boner relies on blood flow and messaging from your brain, alcohol consumption alters that signal radically. Your body's working overtime trying to deal with and process all of the alcohol, so the signal from your brain to send blood flow to your wiener doesn't happen. I mean, look, most of you guys know that I like my wine and I'm also getting into rye whiskey, so I'm not here to preach. But the simple fact is, if we're gonna sit there and polish off 5 or 6 sugary drinks, we might as well plow through a box of donuts, right? It's just something to think about, me included. So back to testosterone for a minute. One way to increase your testosterone is to lift heavy weights and use your bigger muscles. Because when you lift heavy, you're breaking down your muscle fibers, and when you sleep, your body is working to repair that damage to build bigger muscle. Your body works to produce more testosterone to help in that repair process, because if you just sit in a chair all day, your body doesn't really need to produce more testosterone because nothing needs repair. Now, I know that's sort of oversimplified, but that's essentially what's going on, and it makes sense. And lastly is to work on reducing your overall stress. Whether it's work-related, personal life-related, or finance, do what you can to reduce the amount of daily stress in your life. Because just like alcohol, stress blocks the signal from your brain to your penis because your brain is trying to deal with all the chaos and all the emergencies going on. The last thing your brain wants to do is take away processing power so that it can give you a quick boner. And I've said this before, but try to spend some time for yourself to relax and decompress. Chill out. Meditate. Go for a walk, get a massage, listen to a funny podcast so that you can laugh at something. Look, gentlemen, if you don't already know it by now, I only want the best for you. And the whole point of this video is to let you know that number one, you're not alone. And number two, you have options. So if you're not performing the way that you know you can, do something about it. Don't just sit there and tell yourself that it's a normal part of life because you're 42 years old while you're sitting on the couch sucking down your 7th beer. Guys, try something different and try some of the things on this list because they're all proven and shown to work. All right, thanks for watching. And if you're not yet a subscriber, please consider doing that right now. And I'll see you in just a few days for another brand new video. But until then, my friends, live well, and I do hope to see you again very soon.